فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The second one is called the Mutawassitin, the middle one. They're the middle generation, the middle scholars. And this starts from when 403. So it starts after Al-Hasan ibn Hamid onwards. So as after the death of Al-Hasan ibn Hamid until the year 763. And this is the death of, until whose death? Until the wafat of Ibn Muflih. Ibn Muflih, right? Ibn Muflih is the man that Al-Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah saw him. Ibn Muflih, Ibn Taymiyyah saw him. And Ibn Taymiyyah said to him, "You are not Ibn Muflih, you are Muflih." He was a great scholar of the Hanbali Madhab. He has a kitab called Al-Furu'. But the most famous scholars of this tabaqa, the tabaqatul mutawassitin, the middle part scholars, the middle scholars of the Hanbali Madhab, is Al-Qadi Abu Ya'la. Al-Qadi Abu Ya'la, who died in the year 457. 457. Who's very well known as Ibn Farra. Al-Qadi Abu Ya'la, Ibn Farra. Also, Abu Al-Khattab Al-Kawdani, who died in the year 510. He's also from the Tabaqat al-Mutawassitin. We also have Abu al-Wafa ibn Aqil, who died in the year 513. Ibn al-Jawzi, who died in the year 597. Ibn Qudama, who died in the year 620. Abu al-Barakat ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Taymiyyah's granddad, who died in the year 652. Ibn Hamdan, who died in the year 695, and Al-Burhan ibn Muflih, who died in the year 774. This is those scholars I mentioned are the Tabaqatul Mutawassitin. The Tabaqatul Mutaakhirina, the level which are the last, is after the death of Ibn Muflih. And the most famous scholars in the Tabaqatul Mutaakhirin is Al-Mardawi, the author of the Kitab Al-Insaf. He died in the year 885. Ibn Najjar, who died in the year 972. And Al-Hajjawi, who died in the year 968, and Al-Bahuti, who died a year 1051, and Al-Bahuti is what? He was a friend with Muhammad Abdul Wahhab's granddad, Sulaiman. He was a friend and a very close colleague with who? Sulaiman, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab's grandfather, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, Sulaiman. Because Muhammad Abdul Wahhab's granddad was what? He was from the fuqaha and the ulama of the Hanbali Madhab. He was known as the what? The Mufti of Mufti Najd. His granddad, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, was known as the Mufti of Najd. Good. Now we're going to be speaking about, inshallah ta'ala, min al-musannafat, the books that are that to shan, that have a big weight في الفقه الحنبلي in the Hanbali madhab. The first book we're going to mention is the كتاب مختصر الخراقي, and it is from the من أشهر الكتب عند الحنابلة. According to the حنابلة, it is the most famous book. The كتاب مختصر الخراقي. مختصر الخراقي is the most famous, one of the most common book in the madhab الحنبلية. The Madhab al-Hanabila. Also from it is Al-Mughni by Ibn Qudama rahimahullah, which is a sharah of the Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi. Are we all together? ولذلك العز بن عبد السلام العز بن عبد السلام he said I never considered myself to be a faqih. I didn't consider myself to be a person who knows fiqh until I read Al-Mughni by Ibn Qudamah. Al-Izz ibn Abd Salam is saying this. It's from the what? Sultan al-Ulama. Mukhtasar. Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi. Which is a kitab. اعترف أهل العلم بفضله. Other than حتى من غير الحنابلة. Ulama that were not حنابلة testified to kitab al-Mughni by Ibn Qudamah رحمه الله تعالى. Also from the books is the kitab al-Muqna'. Al-Muqna'. The kitab al-Muqna'. Written by and it's written by Ibn Qudamah rahimahullah with the tahqiq of Arnaut. That's the one I have. The Kitab al-Muqni' by Ibn Qudamah, na'am. The Kitab al-Muqni' by Imam Ibn Qudamah. It's the tahqiq of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Arnaut. Na'am. This the Kitab al-Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi, if I'm not wrong. Sheikh Nasir al-Ajmi. Sheikh Nasir al-Ajmi, he has a tahqiq of it. I think he's the best. Let me read the statement of Al-Imam Shaykh Izzuddin ibn Abd Salam from Dahabi's Kitab. What he said. What did he say? He said, مَا رَأَيْتُ فِي كُتُبِ الْإِسْلَامِ فِي الْعِلْمِ I have not seen in the books of Islam book like Al-Muhallal ibn Hazm وَكِتَابُ الْمُغْنِي لِشَيْخ مُوَفَّقُ الدِّينِ Dahabi then, he wrote after him and what did he say? عَقَبَ عَلَيْهِ What did he say? لَقَدْ صَدَقَ الشَّيْخُ عِزُّدِّينَ You see, Izzuddin told the truth. The Kitab al-Muhalla by Ibn Hazm and the Kitab by Ibn Qudam al-Mughni. Those two books is dahab. It's gold. So we have the Kitab Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi and the Kitab al-Muqni' by Ibn Qudama. And with the tahqiq of Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Arnaut. I'm not 100% sure Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi and Nasir al-Ajmi done the tahqiq of it. I think Dar al-Bashair did it. Or even if it's... Maktabat Sheikh Ya'qub Al-Ya'qubi, it might be possible that they did it as well. Also, the other kitab is Al-Insaf by Al-Mardawi. Also, the kitab Al-Sharh al-Kabir Al-Abdulrahman al-Maqdisi. الكتاب الشرح الكبير by عبد الرحمن المقدسي who died the year 680 82. Then we have the kitab المبدع الكتاب المبدع. The Kitab المبدع is a sharah of the Kitab المقنع. The Kitab المبدع is a sharah of the Kitab المقنع by Ibn Qudama. And it's a sharah done by Ibn Muflih, who died in 884. And that book, the scholars, they mention that in reality, it's actually a mubdi'. Mubdi' is when you actually initiate something and you innovate something, you bring something unique to the table. This book, no doubt, in reality, it's a mubdi' fi haqiqati, especially in the taqrir al-aqwal, the way it solidifies and it presents the statements of the madhab and the istidlalat it does for the madhab al-hanbaliyah, it's a kitab which is of higher level. The other kitab is Muntaha al-Iradat. The kitab Muntaha al-Iradat. The kitab al-Muntaha al-Iradat. If you want to get it, you can get the tahqiq of Abdullah ibn Abd al-Muhsin al-Turki. He has a tahqiq on the kitab the Muntaha al-Iradat fi al-Jam' al-Muqni' ma'a al-Tanqih wa ziyadati. This kitab, Muntaha al-Iradat, is written by Ibn Najjar. Muhammad ibn Ahmad al-Futuhi al-Hanbali ibn Najjar, Taqiyuddin. He's the one who wrote it. Very good. Also, we'll speak about this kitab, Muntaha al-Iradat, inshaAllah ta'ala, in more details. The other kitab is Al-Iqna' li-Talib al-Intifa' by Hajjawi. The kitab, Al-Iqna' li-Talib al-Intifa' by Hajjawi. Also from the matter which are very famous is the kitab Zadul Mustaqni' fi Iqtisar al-Muqni'. Hajjawi wrote this kitab, and the Hanabila, they kind of done i'tikaf on that book. This kitab Zadul, the Zad al-Mustaqni' is a mukhtasar of the Muqni' by Ibn Qudama. The Muqni' that I mentioned by Ibn Qudama, the kitab the Zad al-Mustaqni' is a what? Is a ikhtisar of it, summarized it. And this kitab, the Zad al-Mustaqni' qad nala inayat al-azimah. It was given a lot of consideration to. We all together, scholars, they stood over it, they done i'tikaf on it, they studied it, they learned it, they memorized it, they spent their time on that book. One of the ulama who actually explained this book is Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala. He called it Sharh al-Mumti', Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen. And the way Ibn Uthaymeen explains it, it's like he simplifies the whole book. Ajib, the way he explains it. The big kitab, if you try to read it yourself, you need help. You will. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen, he brought it bi-usloobin, qayyimin, in an amazing, profound method of how he brings it forward. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. Also the kitab al-Umda, Ibn Qudama. Kitab al-Umda by Ibn Qudama. Another kitab is the kitab written by Abi al-Khattab al-Kawlad al-Kaludaniyu. Mm-hmm. Let me verify that's how you say it. So yes, Al-Kalwadaniyu. Mm-hmm. It's Li-Abi Khattab Al-Kalwadaniyu. Mm-hmm. Also from the books is Al-Furu' Ibn Muflih. Al-Furu' by Ibn Muflih. The next kitab is Al-Muharrar Li-Majdiddin Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Taymiyyah's granddad. The Muharrar. From them is Al-Irshad by Sharif Al-Hashimi. Who died here for Ibn Taymiyyah's granddad died 652. And Sharif Al-Hashimi died 428. Also the Kitab Al-Mustawa'ib Linasir al-Din As-Samurra'i who died in 616. And from those books is Al-Kafi by Ibn Qudama. Inshallah ta'ala, we're now going to mention some benefits connected to the Madhab al-Hanbali. Some benefits connected to the books of the Madhab al-Hanbali. Inshallah ta'ala, now we're going to mention بعض الفوائد المتعلقات بكتب المذهب الحنبلي. Some benefits that are connected to the Hanbali Madhab. The first benefit, inshallah ta'ala, the first benefit is Ibn Qudama rahimahullah, he authored in the book, I mean, he authored in the Madhab a book for each level. So basically, he wrote a book مراعيا observing طبقات الناس, the people's levels. So if you're a beginner, he wrote the Kitab al-Umda for you. If you're from the Mutawassiteen, or even before we say Mutawassiteen, if you've finished al-Umda and you're over with al-Umda, you've studied it, mashallah, he wrote the Kitab al-Muqni' for you. This Kitab is the book you study after that. Then he wrote another Kitab called al-Kafi. Al-Udhi Zah ibn Qudama. So the first Kitab he wrote is al-Umda, for the beginner. Then he authored al-Muqni'. The Kitab al-Muqni' is the person لمن ارتقى عن درجة المبتدئين. If you just raised yourself from the level of the beginner, he wrote this one for you. Then he wrote the Kitab al-Kafi. The Kitab al-Kafi. So if you are studying al-Umda and the Muqni', you're still a beginner in the Hanbali Madhab. Both books makes you still a beginner. Then you move on to the Mutawassiteen, the middle level. You're within the Hanbali Madhab, you're in the middle level. You study the Kitab al-Kafi. The Kitab al-Kafi by him himself, rahimahullah ta'ala. Then he wrote the Kitab al-Mughni. And al-Mughni is for the person who is the Muntahi. The person who's, mashallah, who's up there. Who's past the level of the Mutawassiteen. So he wrote those books. The first Kitab is al-Umda. Then the Kitab al-Muqni'. And then the Kitab al-Kafi. And then the Kitab al-Mughni. So those four books, if you've not started with al-Umda, then it's min al-Jahalat, it's from the ignorance, for you to be looking into al-Mughni. Because the author, he's now expanding on what he's already said in what? What he said in his previous books. So that tadarruj, that gradual stage needs to be taken by you. Okay? So you state the al-Umda, then you do the Muqni', then you do the al-Kafi, then you go for the Kitab al-Mughni by him, rahimahullahu ta'ala. Very good. Second benefit regarding the Hanbali books is there are three books that are the most famous books within the Hanbali Madhab. They are Hazat al-Shuhra Azima. These books have gained popularity, fame, according to the Hanabila. So they're the most famous books. So you need to have, you keep an eye on these books. The first one is Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi by Umar ibn Hussein al-Khiraqi. That's the most famous book. The most famous book. The most popular book. And it's actually the first Hanbali book written. The Madhab Mutun in a Matan way was the first that was written. And this book was very well studied by the Mutaqaddimin, the early scholars. They studied this book. Then the second book that's very famous is the Kitab Al-Muqni' by Ibn Qudama. Ibn Qudama's Kitab Al-Muqni' is a very famous Kitab. And the third one is At-Tanqih. At-Tanqih by Alauddin Al-Mardawi. At-Tanqih. At-Tanqih. And it's written by Alauddin Al-Mardawi. It's written by Mardawi. Pay attention. Ibn al-Najjar al-Futuhi al-Hanbali rahimahullah. What he did was, Ibn al-Najjar, he authored a book called what? Muntah al-Iradat. The Kitab Muntah al-Iradat, he took the Muqni' by Ibn Qudama, and he took the Kitab al-Tanqih by Mardawi, and with Ziyadat, extra things, he brings it. And then Al-Bahuti rahimahullah, he done a sharah of the Muntah al-Iradat. All together. The Kitab Muntah al-Iradat, what it did was that, how many books did I mention right now from the famous books? Three, right? Put Mukhtasar al-Khiraqi aside from me now. What were the other two? Al-Muqni' by who? I said to you guys, Ibn Najjar, what he did was he took the Muqni'. Okay. And what's the third book that I mentioned? At-Tanqih, right? By who? Al-Mardawi. So what Ibn Najjar did was, he took the Muqni' by Ibn Qudama and he took the Tanqih by Alauddin al-Mardawi together. He put it in one book. He called it Muntaha al-Iradat. Are we all together? He called it what? Muntaha al-Iradat. And he added ziyadat, things that are missing from the both books, Al-Muqni' and the Kitab Al-Tanqih by Mardawi. He put the ziyadat on there, and then after him came Al-Bahuti, as I said to you, who was a friend with who? The grandfather of Ma'an Abdullah. He did a sharah on the Kitab Muntaha al-Iradat. And the best tahqiq of it is the one done by Abdullah Turki. Shah Abdullah Turki's one is the best tahqiq of the Kitab. Are we all together? The third benefit, inshaAllah ta'ala, regarding the Hanbali madhab is the Kitab al-Iqna' by Hajawi. The Kitab al-Iqna' by Hajawi and the Muntaha al-Iradat by Ibn Najjar al-Futuhi. Are we all together? Alayhima madaru fatwa. The fatwa that you would give according to the Hanbali madhab revolves around these two books. Al-Iqna' by Hajawi and the Muntaha al-Iradat by Futuhi. Futuhi died in 972. The fatwa and the qada that the mutaakhirin of the ulama of the Hanbali madhab, the late comers, their fatwa and their qada revolves around these two books. If you see the Hanabil who give fatwa today, listen. Fatwa. Or even if you go to Saudi Arabia and you see the qada and the judgments and the qararat that they bring, whether it be Hayat Kibar al-Ulama's fatwas, or whether you look at the qararat al-Majma' al-Ulama, Rabidat al-Alam al-Islami, are you with me? Fatawa in the Haram, if you listen to the Mashayikh, the fatawas that they give in the Haram, you realize Madaru fatwa, their fatwas revolve around this Kitab al-Iqna' and it also revolves around the Kitab what? Iqna' is written by Hajawi, rahimahullah, and the other Kitab is the Muntaha al-Iradat. And the Muntaha al-Iradat, as I said to you, is a what? Muntaha al-Iradat by Ibn Najjar al-Futuhi is a compilation, it's a combined of the Muqni' by Ibn Qudama and the Tanqih by Alauddin al-Mardawi, rahimahullah ta'ala. That's fa'ida. That if you travel to China for, it's worth it. Those three benefits. If alone you went for China just to get those three benefits, it's actually really worth it. Now. Same person. Ibn Najjar al-Futuhi is the same person. Are we all together? Now good. We're going to now go to the Mustalahat al-Hanabila, the terms that the Hanbali use. The Hanabila, they have terms which they use. Now, brothers and sisters, when you're studying a madhab, we always say this, you have to understand that the terms the scholars of that madhab use. If you don't know what their terms are, when you read their books, you're going to be confused. And you won't give a correct answer according to the madhab, right? The first one is al-riwaya. Al-riwaya. That's the first term that they would use. When they say al-riwaya, what do they mean? They mean the narration from the Prophet? No. They mean al-qawl al-mansub lil Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. The statement that's attributed to Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Number two. When they say tanbihat. If they say nabbaha alayhi al-Imam Ahmad. If they say nabbaha, tanbih is a plural, nabbaha is a singular. Nabbaha alayhi al-Imam Ahmad. When they say that, what do they mean by that? Or when they say at-tanbihat, or when they say nabbaha alayha al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, alayhi al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. When they say, what do they mean by that? فَهِيَ الْأَقْوَالَ الَّتِي لَمْ تَرِدْ عَنْهُ بِعِبَارَةٍ صَرِيحَةٍ بَلْ فُهِمَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ قَوْلِهِ. It is a statement that hasn't come from Imam Ahmed directly. It hasn't directly come from him like this. But it's what has been understood from his statements. عليه رحمة الله. Are we all together? This has been understood from Imam Ahmed. It's been understood from him. But he hasn't said it directly. He hasn't. The next term that they use is the word al-awjuh. Al-awjuh. When they say al-awjuh, it means al-aqwal inda al-ashab. It means the statements that are present with the scholars of the madhhab al-hanabila, the Hanbali madhhab. That this is statements that are present within the statements that are present within the scholars of the madhhab. Some of the terms that they use is the mutaqaddimun, mutawassitun, and mutaakhirun. They would use those terms. And did we explain what each one is meant by? Yeah, we did. We said that what the mutaqaddimun is, and who is the mutaqaddimun. We mentioned what time to what time is the mutawassitun. And we also mentioned the mutaakhirun, the latecomers. All three we spoke about, correct? Yeah? We spoke about. Very good. Now I'm going to move on to, inshallah ta'ala, one of the most famous terms and letters of words that they use in the Hanbali books. There are terms that you would find present in the Hanbali books. Three terms I want you to remember when you read the Hanbali works and their books. Three terms, they all mean the same, but not in terms of strength. It's the usage of the word hatta. The word hatta and the word in. And the third one is low. So hatta, in, and low. The difference between the three is when they say hatta, they mean that the khilaf in this matter is very strong. مثلا they say لا تجوز الصلاة, that salah is not permissible, في أوقات النهي, at the times when it's prohibited. There are times that the Prophet ﷺ prohibited prayer, صح? He said you can't pray these times. They say لا تجوز الصلاة, salah is not permissible, في أوقات النهي, the times when the Prophet prohibited it. حتى ما له سبب. So what comes after حتى is now a they're using hatta because they're trying to show you the khilaf, but they're trying to say that the khilaf here is qawi, is very strong difference. The khilaf here is strong. Hatta ma lahu sabab, even the prayer that has a reason. There are some prayers that have reason. Like for example, tahiyatul masjid has a reason because you're greeting the masjid. So they say that the statement is saying that the salah is prohibited. You can't pray even at the times when it's prohibited for you to pray. You can't pray even if you're praying a prayer that has what? A reason. Hatta ma lahu sabab. The word hatta has been used here. If the word hatta has been used, عند الحنابلة, what you need to know is إشارة للخلاف القوي. This is trying to tell us that the difference in this issue is very strong. Okay? If the word in was put in there, if the word in is put in there, then this is what? للخلاف المتوسط. The khilaf here is moderate. The khilaf here is moderate, is in the middle. Okay? And if the word low is used, after the word hatta, low is used, then this shows isharatan lil khilaf al da'if. It shows that the khilaf is actually very weak. So that's the level. And these huruf, these three hurufs, hatta and in and low, these huruf, when the student of knowledge reads them, and he doesn't know the meaning, then he's going to be unjust and incorrect in what he understands from the Imam of the Madhab. Hatta means something, in means something, low means something. And each and every one of them, they show khilaf is present. But the quwwah of the khilaf, the strength, and the weight of the khilaf differs from the usage of one over the other. When hatta is used, is what? Very strong. When in is used, the khilaf is mutawassit, it's in the middle. And when low is used, the khilaf is what? The khilaf is khilafun da'ifun, the khilaf is very weak. Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, rahimahullah. Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, rahimahullah. He has a kitab called Al-Madkhal ila Fiqh Imam Ahmad, where it's an introduction into the Hanbali madhab. An introduction. If a person really wants to understand the Hanbali madhab, Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd wrote a nice kitab for them to have an insight of the madhab. And he speaks about these hadith huruf al-thalatha, these three huruf. حتى low. And the difference that he has. Go to the first volume, page 320. The book is two volumes. Go to first volume, page 320. Inshallah, Bakr ibn Sheikh Bakr ibn Zayd, who's an imam, an alim, a scholar of the Hanbali madhab. He goes in details with this issue. Here, alhamdulillah, we've concluded and we've finished the Hanbali madhab. We spoke about the imam of the madhab and who he is. We discussed it properly. We now, inshallah ta'ala, we also, sorry, spoke about the mustalahat al-hanabila, the terms that the Hanbali scholars and the imams of the Hanbali madhab use. We spoke about that as well. We also spoke about the books that are written in the Fiqh al-Hanbali and the amount they are and who authored it and a bit about it. We also even spoke about بعض الفوائد المتعلقة بكتب المذهب الحنبلي, some benefits that are connected to the Hanbali madhab. We saw that it's important that we speak about the madhab al-zahiri. The madhab al-zahiri, we should speak about it inshallah ta'ala. But we won't speak about it today inshallah ta'ala, we will conclude there. We'll stop at the Hanbali madhab today. And inshallah ta'ala, we will speak about the madhab al-zahiri next inshallah ta'ala week. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه